Welcome back to another pristine production. I want to shout out to all the fans. Let me hit me up on my YouTube page. Check out my Coursecraft link and my website if you want to buy dancehall, soca, reggae, trap beats. And today we've got a very special session here. We're going to talk about how to mix 808 here. We're going to talk about how to get that tight sound. And we're going to share some tips and tricks using Studio One, Sample One. So let's go right into it. So I got a trap beat here, adding a little bit of Caribbean flavor to it here. So I'm gonna start off with the drum kits here. Very simple beat here. This is what I have here. What I'm doing with this hi-hat here, I'm doing some step recording here to speed up the individual notes. This is what most producers do when they're creating trap beats here. So I'm going to play a little bit. Let me go to the... There it is. So I have the individual notes here with a little bit of step recording to get that sound. And I have the kick drum. Now, let's talk about the 808 here. So I'm going to bring up a sample one here. And I selected an 808 sample here. And my recommendation, guys, there are great 808 plugins, VSTs out there. But most of the time, correct me if I'm wrong, guys, or you might feel differently. I respect that. Most of the time, these big producers are using the 808 sound because it's tighter. So I can hit the note here. And now with sample one, I can increase the release here. Or I can let it be as fast so it stops as I play the key. And what we can do here, if I can isolate that 808 there. We can add some drive here in the filter. Add a little bit of punch here. I want it to be smooth, like an R&B vibe here. I can mess around with the attack here to smooth out the initial hit. I can bring the attack down. And also I can go into loop mode here, or release or sustain here. And I can tune it as well. Now the trick here, we want this 808 to blend in with the drums here. If you listen to the kick is a little bit tough and hard there. Some of you might want that, but we're going to add a little bit of EQ here. We want to maintain that that punch, so I'm going to go. Take a little bit of mid-range here. Now for the 808 here, we're going to be doing a little bit of EQ here. So I'm going to pull in my EQ here. What we're going to do, we're going to take out a little bit of bottom end here from the 808. Let's go maybe about 40 here. Take out just a little bit of resonance there. Let's see how it stacks up with the drums. you want to make sure that the 808 is not fighting with the kick. Now this is where compression comes in. So I'm using the Tricomp here from Studio One here. I'm going to enable that here. So what I'm doing here, I'm setting the release to fast. This is a trap beat here. Here is the attack control. Remember, I taught you guys in a previous video how do you set a compressor. If you haven't seen that already, you can go back to my older videos and check it out. I can set it on auto. We want to set it on a slow. Slow means you're letting more of the transient through and controlling it here. So I'm going to do some compression here. I can add saturation of the compressor. Really give it that grime there. Let's push it until we get some gain reduction here. If I go to fast, you gotta compress it too much. We wanna keep the power of the 808 here. Now let's bring in the drums here. So this is roughly compressing about 2 dB the most. Before. After. So the tri-comp is smoothing out that kick drum here. I can bring in the instrument. Listen to the relationship with the 808 and the kick drum. The 808 is not sounding like it's fighting against the drum anymore. It's becoming a part of the drum here. Let's see what happens if we put it to fast attack here. Even softens up some more. Instead, you can see the compressor is compressing like about 3 or 4 dB here. If I go to slow, I'm getting a little bit more of that 808 body there with less compression but still controlling the transients here. With a little help of the EQ, taking off a little bit of the sub end, just about 40, a little bit of the bottom, the lower mid range here. We're smoothing out that 808 and getting that nice grime and that power coming through. So I'm going to leave out there with you guys. I'm going to catch you guys on the next one here.